A lot of this isn't going to make sense to you. And I'm sorry about that.
I'm just going to start at the beginning with the house. Someone had put up a chain link fence, but it looked like I wasn't the first person to hop it.
My brother Milton disappeared when I was 4. It was like the house just swallowed him up. I lived here until I was 11, but I wasn't allowed inside half the rooms. Inside the mailbox were bills from 7 years ago, marked urgent, open immediately. I hadn't been back since my brother Lewis's funeral. In her will, my mother left me a key, but didn't tell me what it unlocked. Maybe she thought I'd know. Or she thought that the mystery would be enough to bring me back. The truth is, even after I inherited the house, I never thought I'd come back to it. But now I had questions about my family that only the house knew the answers to.
The woods around the house have always been uncomfortably silent. As if they're about to say something, but never do. The house was exactly like I remembered it, the way I'd been dreaming about it. I asked Edie once about the dragon in the pond. She said it had killed her husband. I was 6. It seemed like an odd joke to me, even then. As a child, the house made me uncomfortable in a way I couldn't put into words. Now, as a 17-year-old, I knew exactly what those words were. I was afraid of the house. I heard something moving around in the garage. I hoped the key might unlock the front door. It didn't. Looking in, I felt like the house itself had been waiting for me. Crawling through the doggy door used to be a lot easier when I was 11. The power had been turned off the night we left. For the first time in years, I felt like I was home. But instead of a family, there were just memories of one. Like how only one restaurant would deliver to our house, so we had Chinese a lot. Or how after Lewis started working at the cannery, we all got sick of eating salmon. Except our cat, Molly. The
table was still a wreck from the night we left.
It was like a bomb had gone off, killing everyone but sparing the furniture. Nothing in the house looked abnormal. There was just too much of it, like a smile with too many teeth. Even the fireplace had a story. Edie told me the bricks came from the original house, after it sank. Mom always told me to stay out of the basement, so I wasn't too surprised when the key didn't fit. Great-grandpa Sven built a music box for Barbara, along with the rest of the house. A lot of things got left behind in the whirlwind of that last night. My mom wasn't much of an optimist, but she never stopped believing that my brother Milton was alive. Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library. After Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes.
My Grandpa Sam spent 7 years sharing a room with his dead brother, Calvin. As a kid, I just assumed every house had peepholes and sealed rooms you weren't allowed inside of.
The last time I was in Edith Senior's room, I was 10 and she was painting my portrait.
Whenever people ask me about my family, the first thing they always want to know about is Barbara. Edie's father, Odin, built the original house.
Barbara was a child star for 2 years, until America grew out of it. Mom must have locked the third floor stairs on the night we left. I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room. I think my mom sometimes regretted not sealing it up.
Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him. Turns out, my mom was really good at keeping secrets. Now it was time to find out what my mom had been afraid of.